Messie Jésus-Christ, bénis-nous, mes frères et sœurs, ce matin. May the Lord Jesus Christ bless you, my brothers and sisters, this morning. Amen. I believe that we come to worship the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Him who died for us at Calvary. Amen. I believe we are happy to find ourselves in His presence this morning. Amen. When you come to worship the Lord, you must come with fire in your heart. You must come with joy. Amen. Can you imagine the wise men this morning when they got to Jerusalem? Amen. The Jerusalem was on fire. They said, we come this morning. We come to worship the King. Where is the King of the Jews? We come to worship Him. We see the star from the east. And we come to worship this morning. Amen. We see the word of God manifested from the west. And this morning we come to worship. Amen. We are the true worshipers this morning. Are you the true worshipers this morning that come to worship the Lord? Amen. Amen. Make noise unto the Lord. Worship the Lord. Thank you, my Lord. Amen. While we're going to stand, we're going to stand and we're going to sing Eli Elohim. We come to worship you this morning.
I will.
Alléluia. Merci Seigneur. Alléluia. We are standing on holy ground this morning. There are all angels around. They come to worship with us. Amen. Do you believe that? Amen. There are angels all over. Amen. Hallelujah. That is the safest place you could be this morning. To be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Pendant nous campons, while we stand, en nous lisons devant pour la gloire de Dieu. Let us read Psalm 30 for the glory of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. It is a privilege for us. It is an honor for us this morning to come worship the mighty conqueror, the mighty King of Kings. Hallelujah. Amen. Psalm 30. I will exalt thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up and hast not made my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord, my God, I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive, that I should not go down to pit. Sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of Israel, and give thanks at his remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but a moment, and his favor is like weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. In my prosperity I say, I shall never be moved. Lord, by thy favor thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. Thou didst hide thy face, and I was troubled. I cried unto thee, O Lord, and unto the Lord I made my supplication. What profit is there in my blood when I go down to the pit? Shall the dust praise thee? Shall it declare thy truth? Hear, O Lord, and have mercy upon me. Lord, be thou my helper. Thou hast turned for me my mourning into dancing. Thou hast put off my sackcloth and girded me with gladness. To the end that my glory may sing praises unto thee, and not be silent. O Lord my God, I will give thanks unto thee forever. Amen. Can you see that this morning? I will give thanks unto thee forever, Lord. I will praise the name of the Lord forever. No matter what come my way, I will praise the name of the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Merci Seigneur Jésus. Thank you, my Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Madame Campi, hallelujah. We are talking to God. But if I were to open the service by his prayer, amen, this morning.
Padre Celestial, estamos muy contentos esta mañana por estar en tu presencia. Gracias porque has cumplido tu promesa.
Que donde quiera
que están dos o tres en tu nombre,
tú estarías allí entre
ellos. Padre, rogamos que desciendas entre
nosotros
de una manera tan palpable y poderosa. De manera que ningún enfermo salga
enfermo.
Cada uno sea sanado.
Everyone will be healed.
Que cada uno que vino con problemas,
all those who came with the problem,
sea liberado de
would be
carga.
Set free from their problems.
Que haya gozo en el corazón del pueblo.
There will be joy in the heart of the people.
Que haya espíritus malos tratando
if there are evil spirits that are trying to hinder the blessing, let's cast them out in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
And
we declare us free. And we claim freedom.
Libertad en el campamento
de Dios. Liberty in the camp.
Por la sangre del Señor.
By the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Por el poder del Espíritu Santo.
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
Porque donde está el Espíritu de Dios, ahí hay libertad.
That is, there is freedom.
Oh, Dios bendiga aquel que traerá la palabra esta mañana.
The person who will bring the word this morning.
Y háblanos a nuestros corazones.
And speak to us, to our hearts.
Que podamos guardar este día en nuestras memorias para siempre.
That we will keep this, oh God, in our memories forever.
A causa de tu presencia.
Because of your presence.
En nombre del Señor Jesús.
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. 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 This is the year of Jubilee.
Amen.
Is that your year of Jubilee this morning?
Amen.
Amen. So I see how near.
Yeah.
Ah.
We come to worship one thing this morning. And he's among us sitting up this morning. Hallelujah. That's why we are shouting this morning. Because the Lord is in us. Amen. We have the strength to shout this morning. Hallelujah. Shout unto the God, to the Lord. Hallelujah. You praise unto the Lord. You are the people of the Lord. The Lord has chosen you in this generation. We shout for him. Amen. Amen. Est-ce que vous êtes matin? Are you happy this morning? Hallelujah. It seems like there's nobody wants to sing for the Lord this morning. Nobody has a special for the Lord this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. Anyone has a special for the Lord?
Amen.
Nobody has a special. Amen. Amen. My brother has a special for the Lord. Amen. Amen.
Alléluia, alléluia, chante Jésus, alléluia, louez son nom, Emmanuel.
Victory for us. We are sons and daughters of the living God. Amen. So we must walk as the victorious. Because the Lord done it for us.
Amen.
Our hearts shall be glad this morning. Are you glad this morning? Let us stand.
Bien-aimé Père Céleste, l'auteur de la vie, l'auteur de la parole, Dieu d'amour, dans les précieux noms, notre Seigneur et Sauveur Jésus-Christ, comme je le vois en matin, nous te remercions pour grâce, et merci pour amour, et nous te remercions Seigneur, est-ce que si nous sommes capables là matin, pour nous adorer, pour nous gloire Seigneur, mais c'est grâce à vous, Seigneur, parce que Seigneur, même si on l'a tué dehors, il n'y a pas d'ombre, en dehors de sa volonté, nous-mêmes tout Seigneur,
Abraham de Bezoyon, au petit Isaac, il voyait la ce matin. Dieu vous bénisse ce matin. Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni ce matin. Nous allons
juste un petit moment.
Ce matin, nous saluons. Amen. Dans le précieux nom. Et sauveur Jésus-Christ. Amen, amen, amen. Nous saluons ce matin. Dans le précieux nom. Et sauveur Jésus-Christ. Amen. Combien vous dites quoi de là ce matin? Ils sont fidèles.
C'est
la promesse de Dieu. Si vous êtes deux ou trois, il est là-bas.
Il est là-bas.
Vous savez du cœur à moi. Et c'est ça fait.
And that's what makes me happy.
If you
believe that this morning, that must be your joy.
Hallelujah, Jesus.
Ourselves the way we came.
Amen.
We should have perished. We should have been done with. But the grace of God, the love of God, has been manifest towards us. Lord Jesus, why do we come here this morning? We don't come here to see one another, but we come to celebrate the resurrection of our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. For this reason, when you come to celebrate, you don't come with sadness, but you come with joy. Because you come to celebrate. Because you recognize his resurrection. The resurrection of Jesus Christ. What does it do for you? You recognize it.
Amen.
But he tells us, don't look at your condition. The only thing you need to know, because in the Old Testament, when the sinner would come with his sacrifice,
amen.
They brought it to the priest.
Amen.
What does the priest do?
As
the sinner places his hand on the sacrifice, which means he should have died. But this sacrifice has taken his place. It is your he should have died. Jesus Christ came down. He took my sin. Who will be the seal for their blood? God no longer sees your sin. That's why he said, if the sins were dark, red as scarlet, you will wash them down with white, lighter than snow.
The
prophet tells us, when we look at red through red, it looks white.
Amen.
We are happy this morning.
We are happy
Brother Timothy this morning.
Amen. Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni. Amen. Amen. Qui prend le baptême du
Jésus. Receive his baptism today. Amen. Alléluia.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Amen.
Et jeune frère a demandé baptême déjà.
That young brother had already asked for his baptism.
Lorsque il était 11 ans.
When he was 11.
Amen. Mais pasteur a dit.
But the pastor had said.
Il va croire juste.
He didn't believe it right.
Amen. Mais prophète a dit.
But the prophet says.
Il demande prophète à qui l'on
dit prophète. When is the right time to baptize a child?
Amen. Prophète a dit.
Prophète says.
C'est lorsque tu m'en.
When the child is able to ask for his baptism.
Si prophète a dit ça.
The prophet says. Who am I? Who are you?
Alléluia pour être tu m'en.
To hold back the child.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus. Amen. Sois béni. Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus. Sois béni. Et notre précieux frère aussi.
And our precious brother also.
Invite la congrégation.
Invite the congregation.
Après le service là.
After the service. He would like to have a little fellowship with the congregation
pour nous manger quelque chose,
to eat a little something.
Nous avons fait ça avant de faire baptême non?
I believe we would do that before we do the baptism.
Parce que baptême non c'est les copains pour nous aller.
Because the place where we're going, Lake
Les Popcorn,
Popcorn, the place where we're going, I believe. It's about 30 to 35 minutes from here. Because the brother asked to be baptized in natural water.
Amen.
We know the way we used to do it in the tub.
And
there are
many places they do it.
But the brother asked to be baptized that way. We will do everything we can to bring that to our brother, the desire of his heart. Don't forget this. So we don't see this morning.
Amen.
May the Lord
meet
them and be with
them. We have a
brother Bartholomew who's not with us this morning. Because he's going to Chicago. We have brother Christy also and his family. Who have moved to Georgia.
Amen.
May the Lord be with us this morning.
May
the Lord be with us. Frequent greetings to the congregation.
Amen.
Don't forget
to remember God in our prayer. We have
worshiped
Brother
Christian
also who preached for us.
Amen.
He says greetings to the congregation.
We say in the name of Jesus.
Amen. This morning. We say in the name of
Jesus.
Glorified this morning.
We say in the name of Jesus.
He is a great king. He is the king of kings and the Lord of lords. Before our God, we can say, all things are possible. For this reason, let us stand this morning.
Glory
to Jesus.
Amen.
Let us sing this song.
We have received a message.
Amen.
How many of you
have received the message from the Lord? God doesn't ask you to do anything. Only to look and live.
Amen.
Only look and live.
Amen.
God does it so simple.
Amen.
While the people
Amen.
Are giving themselves problems,
they
went to seminaries and
stuff.
To do the things of God. To make it complicated. So God came down. He did it so simple.
That's
the reason why Isaiah tells us the things of God. They are so simple. Even a foolish person will not miss the
I have a message from the Lord. Alleluia. A message unto you, my King. The King of Kings, the Lord of
Lords,
oh, we appreciate you this morning.
Matin, Seigneur.
Lord,
Seigneur,
we thank you, Lord.
Remercie, Seigneur.
No wonder the Bible says,
by
Lord,
que la Bible dit, Seigneur,
oh, the son and daughters of God,
fils et les filles de Dieu,
are being led by the Spirit of the
Living God. Vivant.
Lord Jesus,
Seigneur Jésus,
we thank you for thy mercy.
Pour ta miséricorde.
We thank you, Lord, for calling us, Lord.
Nous.
And the Bible says, Lord, them that you fold you,
you
are predestined, Lord. Them that you are predestined, Lord, you call them. Them that you are called, oh, you
call
them. Vous justifiez et vous glorifiez.
Sauveur Dieu,
we are worthy.
Nous pas dignes.
We are worthy, Lord.
Nous pas dignes, Seigneur.
We are the good Lord.
Nous pas bon, Seigneur.
But Lord,
mais Seigneur,
we are for grace.
Nous jouons grâce.
You let us know, Lord.
Nous nous connaissons, Seigneur.
We should not know.
Nous pas
devons
pécher nous.
And our mistake, Lord.
Et nous, Seigneur.
And what you have done, and what we have done before.
De ça que nous faisons devant. Mais Seigneur, regardez.
And the perfect sacrifice.
Le sacrifice parfait.
Et
vous nous vivez.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Merci, Seigneur Jésus.
For the message full of grace.
Le message de grâce,
Lord Dieu, que vous voyez vous-même. And this last day.
En ces derniers jours.
My Savior, my God.
En ce moment, mon Dieu.
All the Bible says.
La Bible dit.
That the Lord God.
Le Seigneur Dieu.
Will not do nothing.
Pas rien.
But first.
Pas avant.
Il est si que God.
Il est ce que.
À
ses serviteurs, les prophètes.
My Savior, my God.
Le Seigneur, mon Dieu.
I reserve the brothers and sisters.
Chaque frère, chaque soeur.
That come before
you. Il vient devant au matin.
My Savior, my God.
Le Seigneur, mon Dieu.
You know that.
Vous prenez besoin
de
venir, mon Seigneur. Et pour voir besoin, venir, mon Seigneur. Et pour voir besoin, venir, mon Seigneur. Et faire quelque chose parmi nous.
Parce
que nous sommes le Seigneur Dieu, la servie à
vraiment.
Nous sommes Dieu vivant.
Et
il a le même hier, aujourd'hui et éternellement. Chaque frère, chaque soeur, Seigneur, que nous parlons, Seigneur, ma paix, nous le voyons devant, Seigneur. Même bénédiction.
You are ready, Lord.
You are ready, Lord.
You are ready,
Lord.
You
are ready,
Lord.
You
are ready, Lord.
You are ready, Lord. You are
ready, Lord.
You are ready,
Lord. You are ready, Lord.
You are ready, Lord.
You
are ready,
Lord. You are
ready, Lord.
You are ready, Lord.
You are ready, Lord.
You are ready,
Lord.
You
are
ready, Lord. You
are ready, Lord. You are
ready, Lord. You are ready, Lord.
You
we are going to speak.
Nous allons parler.
About that goodness this morning.
Sujet de ta bonté ce matin.
May you come, Lord Jesus.
Va venir, Seigneur Jésus.
Et
ouais, congrégation.
Take me out of the way.
Retirez-moi sur le chemin.
May you bless us.
Va bénir nous, Seigneur.
And we leave this place.
Et nous quitte place là.
May we say.
Nous allons dire.
Just like us two.
Les deux disciples, Seigneur.
On the road of Emmaus.
Sur la route de Emmaus. Est-ce que nous allons brûler en nous? Pendant que tu as parlé avec nous matin.
Parce
que au nom de Jésus, mon Sauveur et mon Dieu, que nous prions. Amen.
God
bless you.
Amen. Now we will be ce matin.
Let's open our Bibles this morning. We're going to have a review.
Amen. In Apocalypse.
In Revelation.
Amen. Comme le prophète nous dit.
As the prophet tells us.
Amen. C'est celui que Satan
a écrit. It is two books that Satan hate the most.
Amen. C'est le livre de la Genèse.
It is the book of Genesis.
Parce que Genèse montre
le commencement. Because Genesis shows his beginning.
Et la le livre de l'Apocalypse.
The book of Revelation.
Amen. Montre.
Shows.
Amen. Condamnation finie.
His condemnation, his end.
Vous savez la lire.
He hates the entire Bible.
Mais quel Isaïe?
These two books. He hates them the most.
Quel est notre Seigneur Jésus?
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we bless.
Quel est notre Seigneur Jésus?
In the name of the Lord Jesus, we bless.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
On a le Apocalypse premier chapitre.
Let's go to Revelation chapter 1.
Alléluia, gloire à Jésus.
Lord Jesus.
Oh, frère et sœur, c'est nous-mêmes seulement.
We are the only ones.
Qui recevra le message
de la fin. The message of the end time.
Amen. Qui va prendre l'Apocalypse.
Take Revelation.
Amen. Nous pas utiliser pour connaissance.
We don't use our knowledge.
Mais c'est Dieu qui est saint.
But it is God who came down.
Amen. Qui est interprété.
Interpreted.
Amen. Par lui.
His word.
Amen.
Amen.
No
matter what a theologian may say, that's their own imagination. But God said, He will send Elijah the prophet. May His own name be blessed. The children of God, the seed of Abraham, they rest on the promise of God. Revelation chapter 1, we'll start from verse 9 to 20. Here's what He is saying here. Are we not blessed this morning?
Amen.
Amen. Verse 9 to 20, chapter 1.
Moi, Jean, votre frère, qui est pas avec vous à la tribulation et au royaume, à la persévérance en Jésus-Christ, j'étais dans l'île appelé par nous à cause de la parole de Dieu et du témoignage de Jésus.
Amen. I, John, who also am your brother and companion in tribulation, in the kingdom and patience of Jesus Christ, was in the isle that is called Patmos for the word of God and for the testimony of Jesus Christ.
Je suis ravi en esprit au jour du Seigneur, et j'entends derrière moi une voix forte comme le son d'une trompette.
I was in the spirit on the Lord's day and heard behind me a great voice as of a trumpet.
Qui disait, ce que tu vois, écris-le dans un livre et envoie-le aux sept églises à Éphèse, à Smyrne, à Pergame, à Thyatire, à Sardes et à Philadelphia et à Laodicée.
Saying, I am Alpha and Omega, the first and the last. And what thou seest, write in a book and send it unto the seven churches which are in Asia, unto Ephesus, unto Smyrna, unto Pergamos, unto Thyatira, unto Sardis, unto Philadelphia, and unto Laodicea.
Je me retournai pour connaître quelle était la voix qui me parlait, et après m'être retourné, je vis sept champs de l'or.
And I turned to see the voice that spake with me, and being turned, I saw seven golden candlesticks.
Et au milieu de sept champs de l'or, quelqu'un qui ressemblait à un fils d'homme, vêtu d'une longue robe, et ayant une statue d'or sur sa poitrine.
And in the midst of the seven candlesticks, one like unto the Son of Man, clothed with a garment down to the foot, and girt about the paps with a golden girdle.
Quel est le diable de l'édition sur sa parole?
His blessings upon his word. You may be seated for a moment. Amen.
Amen. Verset 14.
In verse 14.
Sa tête et ses cheveux étaient blancs comme de la neige blanche, comme de la neige. Ses yeux était comme une flamme de feu.
His head and his hairs were white like wool, as white as snow, and his eyes were as flames of fire.
Ses pieds étaient semblables à des lèvres ardentes, comme s'il était embrasé dans une fournaise, et sa voix était comme le bruit des grands seaux.
And his feet like unto fine brass, as if they burned in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters.
La verre de sa main droite, sept étoiles. De sa bouche sortait une paix aiguë à des tranchants. Et son visage était comme le soleil lorsqu'il brille dans sa force.
And he had in his right hand seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his countenance was as the sun shineth in his strength.
Quand je le vis, j'ai tombé à ses pieds comme mort. Il posa sur moi sa main droite en disant, ne crains point.
And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead, and he laid his right hand upon me, saying unto me, fear not, I am the first and the last.
Je suis le premier et le dernier. Et le vivant, j'étais mort. Et voici, je suis vivant au siècle des siècles.
I am he that liveth and was dead.
Je tiens les clés de la mort.
I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I am alive forevermore, amen, and have the keys of hell and of death.
Écris donc les choses que tu as vues, et celles qui sont, et celles qui doivent arriver après eux.
Write the things which thou hast seen, and the things which are, and the things which shall be hereafter.
Le mystère des sept étoiles que tu as vues dans ma main droite, et des sept chandeliers d'or. Les sept étoiles sont les sept anges des sept églises, et les sept chandeliers d'or sont les sept églises.
The mystery of the seven stars which thou sawest in my right hand, the seven golden candlesticks, and the seven golden candlesticks. The seven stars are the angels of the seven churches, and the seven candlesticks which thou sawest are the seven churches.
John was in the spirit under the tree, and heard a voice from heaven.
Thank you.
study this morning
de la vision de Patmos.
About the Patmos vision.
Encore nous dit que le nom du Seigneur
Jésus soit béni. Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit
béni. Alléluia.
Alléluia.
Amen. Nous voyons le commencement chapitre là.
In the beginning of the chapter here.
Amen.
John received a revelation.
Cette révélation que je recevais,
this revelation that John received,
amen, c'est la révélation de Jésus Christ.
It is the revelation of Jesus Christ.
Amen, qu'il voyait à ange.
That he sent to his angel.
Amen, pour témoigner.
To testify.
Amen, que Jésus Christ.
That Jesus Christ.
Amen, est le seul Dieu.
Is the only God.
Amen, je dis en pire religion.
Today, many can say.
Amen, que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni. Jésus Christ est deuxième personne.
Is a second person.
Amen, que la Trinité.
Trinity.
Mais nous voyons comment la
présenté là. The way he presented himself.
Comme
Anna was saying in the Sunday school this morning. He presented himself as the Alpha and the Omega.
Le premier,
the first and the last.
Alléluia, que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Que
son nom soit béni. Est-ce le Seigneur Jésus
this morning.
Oh, alléluia.
Alléluia.
Avant qu'on y a.
Now before.
Que Dieu lui a révélé.
Give John that revelation.
You
let him know who it was that was speaking to him. And he also said, blessed are they who will read.
Amen.
Jesus.
Oh, this
revelation. Blessed are those who will hear.
Only to hear.
That means if you are here this morning and you are able to read it, when this revelation, let's put it this way. This prophecy, when it becomes a revelation, if you're able to sit here to hear it, you are already blessed. Even if you couldn't read, if you hear it, you heard it right. That alone is a blessing of you. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we saw John, he was on the island of Patmos. The Isle of Patmos, what was it? The Isle of Patmos was a place where the Roman Empire used to use for the worst kinds of prisoners. The person who committed the worst crime. This is where they used to send those people. Because it was an island. According to history, there's a lot of wild animals in it. When they would send you there, in a few days you should have died.
In
the name of God, just be blessed.
In
the name of God, just be blessed. Are you truly just wanting to bless the name of the Lord Jesus?
Amen.
If you're unable to say amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. He was in the Isle of Patmos. But before John went to the island of Patmos, something had happened.
Amen. You know?
John says there that he was in the Isle of Patmos. Why? Because
de la parole
of
de
the
Dieu
word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ.
Ça veut dire la parole
that
de
means
Dieu.
The word,
la parole de Dieu.
The word said it.
Amen.
Jesus came
amen.
And vindicated that.
Que le nom du Seigneur soit béni.
We saw John now.
Amen. C'était une dernière apôtre.
He was one of the last apostles. If you go on the internet,
and
if you type in the death of the 12 apostles, you will see it was only John that didn't die as a martyr. Church. Church. Did Jesus Christ change? The God you're serving, does he change? It does not change. The Bible says he's the same yesterday, and today, and forever.
Amen.
Now we found out now. Because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ, John was in prison. The Roman government took John now and they put him in a pot of boiling oil for 24 hours. Church.
Amen.
What did John do? A holy man.
A man who
stood for the word of God. Just man.
Amen.
But they hated him. Why? Jesus said in Matthew 5, whosoever stands,
amen.
Wants to live for righteousness, to live for me, you must be persecuted. Brother, you may say today, well, this word is not true, you may say. All these churches out there, they are comfortable, they are serving God. They have no persecution. But if we go back to the dark ages, we will see how they used to persecute the Christians. What did they used to do? They always testify. They always used to testify about what God had done for them. For this reason now, they had to seal their lives, their testimony with their own lives. They took those people, Jesus be blessed. They'll put them in lions den. They will have lions eat them up. They will take those people, they will tie both hands and legs. And they put them on a fire. They would burn them alive. Who was doing that? Not unbelievers now. The state in the Catholic Church that got together. If you don't believe in what the Catholics said, this was your punishment. That's the way Satan used to kill the believers. Of old, they would take a pregnant woman, they would cut her womb open, they would take the child alive before the family there. Before they did that, they would ask you, if only you would deny the doctrine of the apostle, I would set you free. I said, no, we will not accept this freedom. I'm ready to seal my testimony. I'm ready to see my testimony with my own life. Because Jesus told me that there was a cross for him for me. There was a cross for me. If you want to follow Jesus, if you want to follow Jesus, if there was a cross for Jesus, there is a cross for me. There is a cross for you. The Christian life, it was not easy before. And today, the Christian life will not be easy. What did Satan do? Satan came and used a tactic. What was the tactic that he used? Brother, we were reading a story. I believe it was Thomas. There was a man who acted as if he was a believer. Now he went and dined and ate with Thomas. Amen. After that, he said to Thomas,
Amen,
let's go somewhere with me. And then he went with Thomas. You know what he did? He went into Thomas before the killers now. They would kill him because of sound doctrine. When they grabbed a hold of Thomas, Thomas started to sing. He started to pray. Thomas said, all that time I've been working, today I'm going to get my reward. Now when Thomas stood that way, the man said to the person that was going to kill Thomas, he said, no. Now you shouldn't. Not only Thomas will go now, I'm ready also to go. The same way Thomas said. The man was a deceiver. He had come now. Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
To give Thomas over to these people. But when you look and saw how brave the way Thomas stood firmly for what he believed in. Brother, sister, we want to tell you this morning, the same thing Thomas believed is what you and I will believe today. That is reason, brother, sister. What does Satan do? Satan, he used another tactic.
Amen.
He looked so that when those people were dying, they would go away with joy. So what did he do now? He said, I will not do it this way anymore. Now he's going to let them be released. What will he do instead? He will give them a false doctrine. And then with the false doctrine, now he would kill even more people. That's the reason why you see today,
See, everyone have the freedom to worship whatever they want. No matter what religion you want to belong to, belong to it. But the Lord Jesus said in his word, that he would send.
Amen.
Brother, sister, what did we read here?
Amen.
Let us build a foundation on that. Here's the foundation of the church. He said there, we're going to keep going. Is what he said.
Amen.
In verse 16 is what he says. We'll read that. Let's look at what it says. He saw in his right hand
that
he had seven stars.
Amen.
He said that he was blessed. Out of his mouth came a two-handed sword, and his face was as the sun shining in its strength. When I saw him, I fell down. This is what we mean to tell you here. He had showed you that he had seven stars in his right hand.
Amen.
And that he was walking in the midst of the seven golden candlesticks. In verse 20 is what he says. He said, this is the mystery. Jesus Christ now already interpreted. That doesn't need another interpretation. Brother, how clear can you be? If it's not clear for you this morning, raise your hand. Because he didn't say it. Here's what he said. Remember, he said to John,
somewhere,
what you have seen,
écrire,
write them,
yeah,
and send them
dans église,
to seven churches. Those seven churches he was speaking about that were in Asia Minor, those churches, they had the characteristics of things that were to come in seven dispensations. That means seven church ages. In the name of God, we say thanks be given to God. We know what age we are living in. We say thanks be given to God. God has let us know that this Bible, there is no theology in this world that can give interpretation to this Bible. Because Jesus said, I have hidden those things. Do you think that if a theology was able to interpret the Bible, do you think they would have ever crucified the Lord Jesus? There is no one who would have touched the Lord Jesus. But it is because Jesus said, Father, I praise you. I praise your name. Because you have hidden those things from the eyes of the wise and the prudent, but you revealed it unto babes, children. Brother, sister, when it has to do with the word of God, there is no question, well, it's me, well, I'm the one who knows. It's grace that I give to you. Don't you thank God for his grace? In this day we're living in, this day of confusion, you heard what Jesus said? In Matthew 24, 24, he said, the two spirits, you know that's what Satan has done. Satan is a religious spirit. People don't know that. Satan is very religious. Lucifer wasn't Satan before. God didn't create Satan, but God created Lucifer. What was Lucifer? He was Lucifer. He was the morning star, the day star, rather. Lord Jesus, amen. Lord Jesus, in the name of God, Jesus be blessed.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But it was Lucifer who became Satan because he rejected. He refused to worship God. He wanted to receive worship.
Hallelujah.
As we always tell you, sin did not start on the earth. Sin started in heaven. Why? It was about worship. Lucifer wanted to be worshipped. And today, it is said in Isaiah 14, Lord Jesus, he said that he will build his kingdom greater than the kingdom of Michael. What does that mean? That his kingdom would be greater than Michael's kingdom. Do you think he was lying? He didn't lie, you know. What he said was true. Because Jesus said,
Amen.
He said, fear not, little flock. Your father, who is in heaven, has found it good pleasure to give you the kingdom. When Jesus came, who stood against Jesus? The great religion,
in
the time of Jesus, they stood against Jesus. Why? Because Jesus said, fear not,
Brothers and sisters, amen.
If
you take Isaiah 54 with you, it shows you two women there. What does that mean? When the Bible speaks of woman, that means a church. You are your spiritual cat.
He said,
the woman who is not married, that woman has a lot of children.
Yeah.
But a married woman, she doesn't have many children. That's what Jesus is saying there. Fear not, little flock. Your Father is in heaven. That's found in his goodwill and pleasure to give you the kingdom. When Jesus came, the people of Israel, they were very religious people. Great religion. But how many were following Jesus? At the end of his ministry, he found so many miracles he did before Jesus left. Only 12 left, and out of those 12, one of them was a demon. Did that discourage Jesus?
No.
Jesus wasn't discouraged. Because he knew who he was. He knew. That has to be fulfilled.
Let
his holy name be blessed.
Oh, praise Jesus.
Glory to Jesus.
Let
the name of the Lord be blessed. They took this John we're speaking about now. They put on a pot of boiling oil for 24 hours. Think about it, Church of the Living God. Think about that. You mean to tell me a servant of God who is standing for the word of God, who didn't steal anybody's thing, who didn't kill anybody, you want to take that person because he's preaching the true gospel? The religious people took him.
Oh, hallelujah,
glory to Jesus. And he put him in a pot of boiling oil for 24 hours.
Amen.
God came down.
Hallelujah.
Oh, glory to Jesus. When a man is filled with the Holy Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit of God is fire, and cannot burn a man that is filled with the Holy Spirit of God. This morning, in this age we're living in, it is the same thing again. The man who has received the Holy Spirit of God, you cannot take out what is in that person, because his love is sealed in Jesus Christ. There is nothing that happens to a
Hallelujah.
How can a man be in a pot of boiling oil for 24 hours and nothing happened to him?
But
it's not nothing happened to John.
Listen,
that man is a witch. Because he did that, we have something we're going to do to him. We're going to send him now in the island of Patmos, and all wild lions and snakes and stuff will eat him up. We're done with him. Then, the church was suffering persecution at that time. And John was a prophet. In the first church age, that was the age of Ephesus, God knew if John was free, so God wanted to do something with John. Brother sister, didn't the Bible tell us that the footsteps of the righteous, they are ordered of the Lord? When you are a Christian, not only each and every one of us here, we have testimony that we can give. Even before you became a Christian. There are certain places that you were. Today you should be alive. You should have been dead already. But what did they say? I know why I didn't die here. Now I know the reason why. When Satan tempted me at that point, I know why I didn't fall. Brother, sister, when you know the God you're serving, what can give you problems? The prophet gave us a testimony. There was a young woman who was sick. And then she heard what God was doing. That woman was to have a surgery. The doctor could not do the surgery because of a sickness that lady had. Now they called Brother Branham. Brother Branham went and prayed for the lady. After he prayed for the lady, he said, thus saith the Lord, the woman is healed. The woman was healed now.
Amen.
Now they're going to go have those surgery they were supposed to have. After they did the surgery, the woman's mother went to see
her. And then
God just blessed. She says, "Mother, I'm happy. Now I'm going home."
Mother
said, "Oh, I'm very happy for you.
Because,
you know, it's been very long that you've been here. The children are there, your husband is there. They miss you so much also, you know." She said, "Mother, you don't understand what home I'm talking about." She said, "What home?" She said, "Where I came from, heaven. That's where I'm going."
Amen.
Mother said, "No, don't speak that way." She said, "Mother, give me 5 minutes. I'm going home. Do you know after 5 minutes, the woman died?" When the woman died,
but because of
that miracle that God had worked on her, her entire family accepted the message. They were baptized in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. The prophet wasn't there. When he came back, he heard that the woman died. And then he said, "Oh God, You owe me an explanation. Because you said, thus said the Lord, that she was healed. Why is she dead?" Now the prophet, after he said that, God didn't even pay him any mind. Who are you anyhow? You are a man. God owes you nothing. God reveals himself to whomever he wants. Truly, you are the prophet of God, the servant of God. But you are still a man. You have to know that.
Amen.
After 3 months, while the prophet went hunting, God called him. God said to him, "Remember that woman who died? That's her name. Go to her mother and tell her mother, in such and such a year, didn't the woman fall in water?
That
she had already died at that time.
Amen.
But I resurrected her. I brought her back again. Because her time wasn't yet. Because she didn't know me yet. She didn't make peace with me yet. She was not yet born again. Brother, sister, you know, sometimes you hear many people, they go to sleep, they raise their hands up, they say, "Well, thank you, Lord. I went to sleep last night, and I woke up this morning." You know, brother, you don't know who you are. Brother, a true Christian that is born again, go to Jesus. This is not what's important in your life. Why is this less important in your life? When I went to sleep, if I didn't wake up, where would I have gone? You have to walk. Always say, "Look at it, you have to go." You always recognize that you are a Christian, that you have already passed from death to life. For this reason, nothing can make you be afraid. Amen.
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 Now the prophet went. Went and asked the woman's mother, "Your daughter, didn't she fall in love in this a year?"
They took her
to the hospital, and they revived her. She came back.
Well,
when she fell in the water, she should have died then. But because she was predestined unto eternal life, because she was predestined to be a member of the bride of Jesus Christ, she did not go yet. She had been regenerated. I would not lose not one of those that I knew before the foundation of the world. How many people know this morning that this is who you are?
Hallelujah.
Do you know how you know that this is who you are? Here's the revelation. He said there.
Amen.
The mystery of the seven stars that you see in my right hand and the seven golden candlesticks. Seven stars that you see. What are they? They are seven angels.
Amen.
Or the seven church ages. What does an angel mean? An angel means a messenger.
And
the seven golden candlesticks. What are they? There are seven churches. What does that mean here? That means after Jesus Christ has gone, God will deal
avec sept dispensations.
In seven dispensations.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dispensation
in each one of these dispensations, we can say also ages.
Hallelujah.
God
has
some messengers that were predestined before the foundation of the world to bring a message to each one of those churches. Every dispensation or every church has a messenger that has to preach in it. The first messenger was Paul. So we thank God. You are there. They are the same tradition. You see those ages you see there? This is a drawing you see there. The prophet has drawn this the way you see it there. On the board.
The
name of the Lord just blessed. The name of the Lord just blessed. Glorified. After he drew it, after that he erased it.
Thank you, sir. Amen.
Amen. That picture is there.
Amen.
After God had did it, drawn it, after the prophet drew it, he erased it. After he erased it now, God himself came down.
Amen.
God came down.
Amen.
Before everyone that was here, and drew that same picture that the prophet had drawn on the board. We thank God. I believe 9 years ago, when we had gone to Indiana, we had gone to Jefferson where the prophet used to preach. The prophet's son stood up and he was asking, he asked in the congregation that was there, he said, who was there when my father had drawn the picture of the seven churches? And after he erased it, that guy himself came down visibly. Everyone saw the handwriting without seeing the Bible. Jesus Christ just said, yes, for you today and forever. When the son of the prophet said that, but Joseph, when he said that, there were two people still in the congregation. They raised their hands. They said, yes, we were witnesses. We were there when this thing happened, to show you. Outside of this revelation, there is no truth out there. Because God said in his word, everything you see in this world,
that
is not confusion.
But
God said in his word, in every church, he sent a messenger. If you don't recognize the messenger for your time, you are in confusion. Our God is not a God of disorder. Our God is a God of wisdom. He knows all things. There is nothing impossible. Today you may say, Brother
Dennis,
you mean to tell me the other churches, they're not preaching the gospel also? Yeah. They're preaching the gospel, a past gospel.
Hallelujah.
But God wants for you to be established in present truth, in the message for your time. That's what God wants. Now we saw John.
Put
in the pot of boiling water
for 24 hours.
Nothing happened to him.
They sent him to the island of Patmos.
Now when he got to the island of Patmos,
there,
God started to deal with him for him to write. God gave him a revelation, showed him the seven churches that are to come. He said things that are to come hereafter. He said, write those things that you see and send them to the seven church ages.
Hallelujah.
In the island of Patmos.
Verse
10, he said,
oh,
I was in the spirit.
Amen.
On the Lord's day.
And
he heard behind me.
Amen.
A voice.
Oh, comme le son de
as of a trumpet.
Hallelujah.
He was in the spirit.
Hallelujah.
Lord Jesus. Before you receive anything from God,
amen.
You must be speak in the spirit. That is what Paul said. If you are singing, you have to sing in the spirit. If you are dancing, you have to dance in the spirit. If you are worshiping, you have to worship in spirit. Before God, we present anything to you. You must speak in the spirit. How do you come in the spirit? You have to come in the spirit. You have to come in the spirit.
Amen. Nous devons laisser quelque chose
de Dieu.
Amen. Que le nom du Seigneur soit béni. J'en dis en esprit.
John was in the spirit.
Amen. Aujourd'hui, Seigneur.
On the Lord's day.
Amen. J'en dis à nous le parlons de
Dieu. Today we talk about the Lord's day.
Pas
don't forget.
Amen. Jean.
John.
Quel est le
nom du Seigneur? How long did he live for? According to history,
Jean de là.
John was there for 2 years.
Dans l'île de Patmos.
In the Isle of Patmos.
La main puissante du Seigneur.
The mighty hand of the Lord Jesus. Was with him. When they look now, that's why nothing could happen.
They
say, that means we have to put him somewhere else.
No,
everything they tried to do with him, nothing could happen to him. Because God wasn't done with him yet. No, brother, you don't know how many demons are unleashed against you. When you accept this message, you heard Jesus say, I built my church upon revelation.
For
the gates of hell will always fight against that truth.
For
the gates of hell will never prevail. You believe that this morning, amen.
Yeah.
You think you're just somebody who's there by chance?
No,
the heavenly host is with you. The heavenly host is with you. Because he's there for this revelation.
Oh,
if God is not with you, then there's no chance for you at all. You're done for.
Amen. Yeah?
But God wasn't done with John yet.
Now
God gave him this revelation in the year
95.
In the year 96. 2 years. He stayed there. Receiving that revelation. That's what we read.
Amen. Oh,
on the Lord's day.
Today,
many people say,
Amen.
On the Lord's day.
Amen. C'est samedi.
It's Saturday.
Some
people say,
the
Lord's day.
Amen. C'est dimanche.
It's Sunday.
Alleluia. Que le nom du Seigneur soit béni.
The Lord be blessed.
Don't
forget.
La Bible écrit.
The Bible was written.
Amen. Par des sorts.
By men.
Remplis.
That were filled. And sealed with the Holy Spirit. Those were men also. These are the kind of men who are all who
with the Bible.
No one has the right to ask their own interpretation in the Word of God. And the only ones who will not be judged, Jesus said, in John 5:24, those who hear my word, don't you say amen? I'm trying to
say
in John 5:24, he said, those who hear my word and believe in him who sent me, they have eternal life. They will not come into judgment anymore. They have already passed from death unto life. When you have the ability to accept the message in your own time, you are going to be the one to judge the world.
Amen.
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 Thank you. Amen.
Amen. On the Lord's day.
Amen. Les jours du Seigneur.
The Lord's day.
Amen. C'est pas le samedi.
It's not Saturday.
Et il part dimanche.
Nor is it Sunday either.
C'est ça le Saint-Esprit.
That's what the Holy Spirit of God has said.
Que son nom soit béni. Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni. Les hommes avaient propre interprétation.
They have their own interpretation.
Amen. Toujours faire la parole de Dieu.
They always make the word of God.
Pas d'effet
aujourd'hui. To make an effect on the people.
Amen. Jésus dit.
Jesus said.
Avec tradition.
With your tradition.
Il a parlé à les Juifs.
He was speaking to the Jews.
Les plus religieux.
The most religious people.
Matthew
16, he said to them, with your tradition,
you
have made the word of God to be of none effect on the people.
Yes.
Yes. Lord Jesus, did you catch that this morning?
Amen.
Yeah? Tradition, Jesus came. They crucified him with
the Jesus.
Today, what happened? Everyone, they are celebrating. Christmas. The birth of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ came. He was risen. Today, everyone is celebrating. That is called Easter.
The Bible
tells us. This is a man's tradition. What should that do? What does it have to do with the resurrection of Jesus Christ? Or little money to pay little eggs and little those are commercial things. They have nothing to do with God. God has nothing to do with those things at all. Men taking the things of God to make commercial, so they can make money.
Oh, hallelujah.
But as we know, Jesus Christ, he never was born in December. He came as the Lamb of God. And lambs are always born in April. Lambs are not born in December. Think about Jesus Christ. He wasn't born in a house. He was not born in a house. So where are lambs born? They are born in a manger. Jesus had to be born in a stable. He was a lamb. If you look at nature, we're not going to let Sam be seen. If you look at nature, you will see Jesus in nature. Right? Glory to Jesus.
Oh, Jesus,
may his holy name be blessed.
Oh, friend.
Brother. The Bible says,
you
know, today they are doing gift exchange.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Let's go, Lord Jesus. Amen. Our time is fast. He said that the Lord's Day
is
not Saturday. It's not Sunday. Because John, he said there that he was with our partners on the Lord's Day.
Amen.
The day he's speaking about here is not a natural day
on the Sabbath.
It is a day of judgment where God will come into judgment with the world.
Today,
many adventists say, if you don't keep the Sabbath, they say, you're not in it. They say, that's the doctrine of the Catholic Church. That you're following when you worship on Sunday. Because they say the disciples, they worship when they say, they say on Saturday. No, you will not find this in the Bible. They used to go to the temple. Paul went.
Jesus.
But 1 Corinthians 16, the first day of the week, that's when they gather. That's what the Bible tells us. So the Lord just blessed. Let's look. Speaking about the Lord's Day.
Amen.
May his holy name be blessed. May his holy name be blessed.
Let's go to
the Lord Jesus. Let's go to Hebrews chapter 4. What the Bible tells us about
Amen.
The Lord's Day.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
The
Lord
Hebrews 4 verses 8 to 11. We'll read that for you.
Amen.
Amen. We have a lot we'd like to speak about this morning, but we won't have enough time to do it. We'll continue in another day. His name be blessed. Hebrews chapter 4.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Verse
8-11.
Is what it says there.
Car si Josué les a donné le repos, si Josué était pas le
repos,
la pour de Josué qui
allait, c'est
Josué qui allait après la mort de Moïse.
Of God after the death of Moses, he was the one that was to take the people and take them into Palestine.
Quel est le nom du Seigneur
Jésus? Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He misses every year now.
You
know, that day of rest that they had in the Old Testament was not the true rest. It was a memorial that God had given them. That memorial had to become a reality. What is the reality? Jesus said in Matthew 5, come unto me, all those who are tired and heavy laden, I will give you rest. I will take your sin. I will put it on me. I will put it on your sin forgetfulness. When you have rest. When you have rest. You have rest. When you receive the Holy Spirit. That's your rest, brother.
Hallelujah.
It's not about, well, I'm not going to eat this. Well, I will not do that. One day. No. Jesus said, you eat everything you can eat. That's what he said. That's what I believe. Amen.
Amen.
If Joshua had given them rest, then you would not have thrown out spoken of another day. There remained therefore a rest to the people of God.
Hallelujah.
There is a rest on Sabbath. That is remains for the people of God.
Amen.
Oh, you're the people of God. Amen.
Amen.
You are the people of God. You will find that rest.
Amen.
That's the only way you can find it. It has to do with predestination.
Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
may
God be blessed.
Amen.
In verse 10.
Because it's him who enters the port of
God.
It's the port of God. Look at that.
Also, I see some of all those who get into God's rest, they rest from their work, they cease from their work. All the old things you used to do, you don't do these things anymore. Today, you see women, men, how they are dressed. You see the world out there, how they're taking their fake hair and hair and all that. Now they want to do the same thing also. Brother, sister, don't do that. Don't copy the world. The Bible tells us, if you love the world and the things that are in the world, the love of God is not in you. What does that show you? That shows that you have not yet come into his rest. When you come into his rest, your eyes are looking at the Lord Jesus. He's the only one who is your all in all.
Oh, hallelujah. Yeah.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen, amen.
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 God did from his.
Amen.
When God rested, after he created everything in 6 days, and he took his rest day. That was the seventh day, right? Did God go back? Did God go back to work again?
No.
No. He didn't go back to create again. He said the same way God went into his rest. That's the way you also will go into his rest. It's not about, well, today I take the rest, but on Sunday you go back to work. That's not the rest. That rest is Ephesians 4, verse 30.
Amen.
Grieve not the Holy Spirit of God, by which you are sealed until the day of your redemption. May the name be blessed. May the name be blessed. Speaking about rest, right from the Old Testament, the prophet of God was speaking about rest. This is what Isaiah said about rest. Isaiah 28. Let's go to Isaiah 28. We're going to see what it says about the rest.
Amen.
People of the Lord Jesus. Amen. People of the Lord Jesus.
Oh, hallelujah.
Brother, sister, if you're not in confusion today, you must praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
It is his grace. It is his love. Because he said in Romans 11, it's not those who are running, not those who are seeking, who will find a way, but those whom he has called. Why has he called you? Because he predestined those he has predestinated, he called them.
Amen.
Yeah. Those whom he has called, he justifies them. When he justifies you, it is as if you did nothing at all. This is what he says. Isaiah 28.
Amen.
We'll start from verse 8.
All
the tables are full of vomit. Isaiah already saw it.
And
the Holy Spirit of God.
Amen, amen, amen.
Because when the prophet comes, he sees the eyes of God. He hears the mouth of God. He's not the one speaking. This is why the Bible tells us. If God says he's a prophet,
or
that he's spiritual, watch that man. What he says, if it comes to pass, then fear that man, because God is with him.
Amen.
But what he says, if it doesn't come to pass, don't worry about him. That man should be stoned to death. Because he is speaking lies. And God cannot lie.
But
all the tables are full of vomit and filthiness. So that there is no place clear. Lord Jesus. What place is he talking about here? You go to a church, you find men, women, people that are all taking communion. Communion must be taken. In a holy vessel, a clean body, a body living for God. But there were men and women living in adultery, even in the church. They have their pastor that they leave the pulpit for 5 minutes to go and smoke. And after that, they come back. All the tables are filled with with filthiness. Now he's no clean table at all. No wonder when Abraham was interceding for us, he asked God, if you find 50, will you burn some up? God said, no. He interceded and he interceded. When you find 10, will you burn some up? No. When you find just one, will you burn some up?
No.
No one was righteous, brother. If you are here today, it's the grace of God. In the name of the Lord Jesus. If there was any righteous, God didn't have to be made flesh to redeem the human race. No one is righteous, but it is the grace of God. As we told you, that sacrifice represented you. What is the sacrifice? The Lord Jesus.
Amen.
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 Verse 9,
he says, unto whom shall we teach wisdom? Knowledge. Whom shall we make understand that? Them that are weaned from the milk?
And from the breast.
Precept upon precept, line upon line. Here a little, and there a little. That's the way the word of God is.
Amen.
But what has been done? If God does something for one year, they all look at what's been done.
They say,
well, we believe God. No, brother, that's not the way you believe God. Do you know how you believe God? You believe God in what God is doing in your time. If you cannot believe God in what He's doing in your time, then you are under judgment.
Amen.
Glory to Jesus.
Que
your name be blessed.
Amen.
Amen. Well then.
It
is by men with stammering lips.
As
the Lord will speak to His people. Brother, sister. To whom did God speak? To whom did God say His word? Is it to a theologian? A man who has a diploma in theology. That's not the way God
does
it. The Bible tells us here. God,
He
sent His word unto men with stammering lips. Do you know what that means? You know, with stammering lips, men who cannot even find the words to say. You know, they're stammering to find the word to say. Men who cannot even speak at all.
Amen.
That God used, because God knows that men with their wisdom, they will not accept such a man. That came from wilderness, they came.
Oh, friendship.
Brother, sister,
imagine.
Think about this. In the days of Israel, God sent a man, John the Baptist. He came out of the wilderness. At the age of 9, he had gone to the wilderness. Now he's coming back. A man full of beard. Maybe he smells bad. He's baptizing people in the Jordan River. He can't even speak. He's speaking like animals. And this is what he said.
So
who warned you? Who warned you? To flee from the wrath to come. Now the axe, he said, it is in the root of the tree. Whosoever tree doesn't bring forth fruit will be cut and torn in the fire. That's the way he spoke. You think Israel will be able to accept the word of that? No, we will not be able to accept
them.
Those are such men with your stammering lips, with another tongue, things that make no sense at all. Those are the people. The Bible tells us here that God uses
to
preach His gospel. Why? Because you know why God does that? How many people know that there are two seeds on the earth? We have the serpent seed and we have the seed of God. The serpent seed is a very intelligent seed. A lot of knowledge they have. But God Himself, you
heard
what the Bible says? The Bible says the children of this world, they have more wisdom than the children of God.
You heard that?
Les enfants de ce monde.
Of this world.
Plus connaissance.
They have more knowledge.
La
Why do they have this knowledge? In the things of this world, in their but ourselves.
Nous,
we have a knowledge.
Connaissance, so
that knowledge is not from down below, but it's from above. It is a revelation that you have received from our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Que son ses noms chambéry.
Your name be blessed.
Amen. 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 Est-ce que
vous Lord Jesus.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Here's the rest, he says.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Ah, Jésus. Verset 12.
In verse 12.
Voici le repos.
To whom he said, this is the rest.
Laissez reposer celui qui est fatigué.
You may cause the weary to rest.
Voici le lieu du repos.
This is the refreshing.
Mais ils n'ont point voulu écouter.
They would not hear.
Amen. Par Jésus.
Lord Jesus.
Et pour eux la parole de l'Éternel.
But the word of the Lord.
C'est un
Taken. Jesus said, if a blind is leading a blind, they will both fall in a ditch.
Amen.
Amen. Your name blessed. Isaiah said,
who has that
fulfilled? When the disciples, they were in the upper room, they were waiting for a promise, and I said, tarry until you receive the power from above. When the Holy Spirit of God came,
les gens religieux,
the religious people,
les gens de Sabbatéliens,
the Sabbatéliens,
ils ont fait comme ça.
They had nothing to do with this thing at all.
Alléluia, grand Jésus.
Mais pour les disciples, for the disciples, it was a promise. That's when they went into that
rest.
At the day of Pentecost, when the Holy Spirit came down,
His
only name be blessed.
Alléluia, grand Jésus.
Glory to Jesus.
Les sons de nos familles.
His only name be blessed.
Est-ce qu'on veut le Seigneur Jésus?
Lord Jesus.
Jean était un esprit.
John was in the spirit. On the Lord's day.
Amen. Oh, first time.
Brother, sister. The Lord's day, we told you.
Amen.
Is a day of judgment.
Alleluia, grand Jésus.
Jesus.
Oh, chantez en esprit.
John was in the spirit.
Nous aimons ça.
We love that.
You
know, I love people
Amen.
That when they come before God, who worship God for real. I love that. Because we must be in the spirit. Think about this, brother, sister. If you go to a nightclub,
Amen.
Amen.
So
you go to a nightclub now, you find people are dancing, and then you yourself cross your arm and you just stay in a little corner.
So
friends who went with you, you know what they'll do? They're going to say, you are like a wallflower. That's what they'll say you are.
Because
everyone is dancing, everyone is rejoicing.
So
you stand like that.
God will tell us,
John was in the spirit. In order for you to receive
anything
from God, you have to be in the spirit.
Jesus
said, repent,
baptize
in the name of the Lord Jesus,
for
the remission of your sins. What must you do?
Do
it in the spirit.
Jesus
said, if they pray for me,
and
they anoint me with oil, I receive my oil. You must be in the spirit. To a football game. Everyone who knows that. How many of you used to watch football so much? Or soccer. And the team that you love does something good. You don't just cross your
arms.
And say, oh, it's a good thing. What do you do? You kick your leg, kick your arm. Why? Because you are in the spirit of the game. You
don't
come before God. You must be in the spirit. He's looking for worship.
Jesus.
His only name be blessed.
Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, man.
Don't forget, the natural explains the spiritual.
Amen.
John was in the spirit.
Amen.
What is wrong with us? Is there something not right? John was in the spirit. And he received the revelation. When you receive revelation, you have to be in the spirit. You have to be stimulated. Lord Jesus.
May
his holy name be blessed.
Lord
Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Victory. Amen.
Victory.
Victory. Victory. Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
When I feel the spirit, j'entends les voix.
And I heard behind me,
il est fort,
a great voice.
Come in trumpet.
As the trumpet, verse 10.
Alleluia, Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
May
his holy name be blessed.
Nous t'entendons.
You heard behind him a voice.
Amen. Come your trumpet.
As of a trumpet.
Alleluia. Avant vous là.
Now before.
Amen. Pour Dieu vous a révélé la chose.
God would reveal himself unto John.
Amen.
John heard a voice as of a trumpet.
Alleluia. Qui ça ça signifie?
What does that mean?
Your personage important. Alleluia.
An important person.
Amen. A fini.
Is coming.
Trumpet sonné.
The trumpet is sounding.
Lorsque Joseph quittait.
When Joseph used to leave.
Amen. Lorsque la montre.
When he was coming in.
Trumpet sonné.
He used to sound the trumpet.
Joseph a fini.
Joseph is coming. When your king is coming, let's sound the trumpet for
him.
Because he's a person, an important person. He's the King of Kings. And he's coming.
The
trumpet must be sounding.
Hallelujah. John
heard a voice.
Oh, que son
nom soit béni.
There
was a voice.
C'était la voix de Dieu.
What was he speaking about here?
La voix des sept messagers.
The voice of the seven messengers.
Des sept anges.
Of the seven angels.
Et dit tout.
And he said.
Que le nom d'Apocalypse
17. Revelation 17 said. Verse 5.
Alleluia, la voix ça commence venir.
That voice has come. It's like the voice of great waters.
Alleluia,
today.
Lorsqu'on est la parole.
When you hear the word.
Et c'est comme si ma voix est signification.
And there is no meaning in it at all.
But
very soon.
Vois ça, tu vois ça quand
le voice that you hear today. That still small voice. But before God, that's exactly what it was.
Amen.
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 May his name be blessed.
Alleluia, gloire à Jésus.
Glory to Jesus. Amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
Verset 11.
In verse 11.
C'est que tu vas écrire dans un livre et envoyer aux sept églises.
In a book and send it to the seven churches.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Be blessed.
À Éphèse,
unto Ephesus,
Asmin,
unto Smyrna,
à Pergam,
unto Pergam,
à Thyatira,
à
Sardes,
unto Sardis,
à Philadelphia,
unto Philadelphia,
et à la Odyssée.
And to the Odyssea.
C'est ça nous parlons.
That's what we're speaking about.
Les sept églises.
The seven church ages.
Et bien, aujourd'hui,
today,
nous n'en dernier âge.
We are in the last age.
Amen.
Amen.
The message was preached.
Your servants before I preached. Not because they were not good. They were good in your time. But today, brother and sister, we are living in another dispensation. We are living in another age. That's the reason why I came down.
Hallelujah.
So there is so much confusion in the world that we're living in today. If God didn't come down mightily and do something miraculous, where would you and I be today?
Amen.
Amen. God has done so much, so many great things. Even science took a picture of him. That means there was no excuse at all to reject it. It's either you reject it or you accept it.
Amen.
But don't forget, God always Amen. Does it in a simple way, amen. God in simplicity. Amen. The name of God just be blessed. Amen.
Amen.
Verse 12 says,
je me retourne pour connaître ce qui était la voix qui me parlait.
Et me retourne.
And je vis sept
golden candlesticks.
Amen. Le prophète nous dit là.
The prophet tells us.
J'ai placé la
sept seven golden candlesticks.
Amen. C'est pas ça le but.
That's not what it should have been.
Amen. Gloire à Jésus.
What should have been?
Amen. C'est lampadaire.
Seven golden lampstands.
Alléluia. Quel est le nom du Seigneur Jésus? Amen. Sois béni.
Let's go to Zechariah.
Amen.
We're going to do what we can to keep you long. We'll continue in another day.
Amen.
Zechariah 4, if you go. We'll see what it says. Zechariah 4, verses 1 to 7. We read this way.
Amen.
And the one that was saying that John was in the spirit.
Amen.
He heard a voice behind him.
L'ange qui parlait avec moi
revint.
Et il me réveilla comme un homme.
And wake me as a man.
Que l'on réveille de son sommeil.
Out of his sleep.
Il me dit.
He said unto me.
Que vois-tu?
What seest thou?
Amen. Je répondis.
And I said.
Je regarde et voici.
I have looked and behold.
Il y a un chandelier tout d'or.
A candlestick.
Surmonté de vases portant sept lampes.
On the top of it.
Alléluia.
Seven lamps.
Amen. Gloire à Jésus. Et avec sept conduits, amen, amen, pour les lampes qui sont au sommet du chandelier.
The seven lamps which are upon the top thereof.
Amen. Et il y a près de lui les deux oliviers.
And two olive trees by it.
L'un à la droite.
One upon the right side.
Et l'autre à gauche.
And one upon and the other upon the left side thereof.
C'est-à-dire, l'Ancien Testament,
the Old Testament,
et le Nouveau Testament,
the New Testament.
Même Jean, nous-mêmes, dans le Nouveau Testament,
in the New Testament,
nous qui sept à l'église,
we have seven church ages.
L'Ancien Testament,
the Old Testament also,
et les sept à l'église,
has seven church ages also.
Alléluia.
Alléluia.
Oh, soit glorifié ce matin.
Be glorified this morning.
Alléluia, gloire à Jésus. Amen. Amen. Verset 4.
Verse 4.
Et reprenant la parole,
so I answer,
j'ai dit à l'ange qui parlait avec moi,
the angel that talked with me.
Qu'est-ce que signifie ces choses, mon
Seigneur?
L'ange qui parlait avec moi me répondit.
So the angel that talked with me answered and said unto me.
Ne sais-tu pas que ça signifie
so
ces choses?
Knowest thou not what these be?
Je dis.
I said.
Non, mon Seigneur.
No, my Lord.
Alors, il reprit et me dit.
He answered and spake unto me.
C'est ici la parole de l'Éternel.
This is the word of the Lord.
Adresse à Jérusalem, à Zerubbabel.
Unto Zerubbabel.
Amen. Ce n'est ni par la puissance.
Saying not by might.
Amen.
Amen.
Ni par la force.
Nor by power.
Mais c'est par mon esprit.
But by my spirit.
Amen. Dit l'Éternel.
Saith the Lord of hosts.
Verset 7.
Verse 7.
Qui es-tu?
Who art thou?
Au grand montagne.
A great mountain.
Devant Zerubbabel.
Before Zerubbabel.
Tu seras à Poulani.
Thou shalt become a plain.
Tu poseras la pierre principale.
Thou shalt bring forth the head.
Au milieu des acclamations.
With shouting.
Grâce, grâce.
Crying grace, grace. Unto him.
Alléluia.
Alléluia.
Que son Seigneur soit béni.
Que son Seigneur soit
béni. Où est-ce qu'on crée nous la
prière? I wish that he showed us there.
Avec les sept ailes de
l'église. The seven church ages.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Amen.
L'aile
de glace, il se
passe
un chandelier d'or.
Parce que si le
chandelier,
lorsqu'elle commence à brûler,
when it starts to burn,
il est fini.
Amen. Mais nous connaissons
dans l'Ancien Testament.
But we know in the Old Testament,
alléluia, gloire à Jésus. Ils ont un gros vase.
They had a big
vase à brûler. Amen. C'est lui qui mettait l'huile là-dedans.
This is where they had placed the oil in the vase. What kind of oil did this there? Olive oil.
And they
were placed
in
there. There were seven pipes now. Now go to seven lamps.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni ce matin.
This morning.
Avec que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni ce matin.
This morning.
Avec pour les premiers lampes.
In order to light the first lamp.
Qu'est-ce qu'ils ont fait?
What did they do?
Amen. Ils ont pris le
sacrifice. They took the sacrifice of the sacrifice.
Amen.
And they lit it from the vase, which means from the fountain, which means from the source.
May his holy name be blessed this morning. No matter what man is doing, God stands with his word.
Amen.
God takes advice from no man. It's not by might. Not because you went to school. Not because you have knowledge. Not because you went to school. It's not by power. In order for you to serve God, for you to know God, it's not by your knowledge, but it is by the Spirit of God. It is by grace that you are saved. And that through faith, not something you can do anything for it at all. The grace of God is a grace that you did not deserve. Unmerited grace. But God in His grace, He predestined. When you got predestined, when were your names written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Today, was it today? When Jesus came and died? 2017 years ago? No. Your name is written in the book of life for them before the foundation of the world.
Jesus
Christ was slain before the foundation of the world. What God says, it is as if it's already fulfilled. God cannot go back upon his word. What God says, he stands with his word. May the word of God be recognized as the truth.
It
is by my spirit,
saith
the Lord of hosts. Amen. Amen. Recognize what God has done for
us.
You know what he said there? Who are you? Mountain. Who are you, great mountain?
Who are
you, great man of this world? Who are you to stand against before Zerubbabel? Who was
Zerubbabel?
Zerubbabel, he was the son of God. You'll fall out anyhow.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Que le nom du Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Que le nom du
Seigneur Jésus soit béni.
Il pose à la pierre principale au milieu.
The headstone thereof.
Oh, alléluia. Combien vous dites
qu'on t'en sait pas. Mais il passe
la
pierre
principale là.
He is the headstone.
Pas principale au milieu.
You know what the headstone is?
Lorsque la partie temple.
Lorsque
Jésus avait le nom des
tiers.
La partie temple.
To build the temple.
Tenez en pierre.
There was a stone.
Au milieu
de tronche. There was
a
Jesus.
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 he placed that stone, the Bible says, he placed that stone in the midst of shouting. Amen. I don't hear you, amen. You heard where he placed it. Who is Jesus Christ? Jesus Christ. He is the Word. Is the Word revealed unto you? What must you do now? Shout for joy. Shouting. Say grace, 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 grace. Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
If you are unable to shout and say thank you, Lord,
for your
presence is
great,
it's because you are not in the mind of God, but someone
tells us.
The deep
calls
into the deep.
What does that mean
to tell you? When
we
hear the word,
amen.
It's not to say, well, it's my first time hearing the word, so the word was already in you. You were predestinated already. That's the reason why when you hear the word, there is something in you. Because you say amen to the word. The deep, and it's falling into the deep. You must have something in you. If you have nothing, everything that's being said here will do nothing for you at all. There's nothing we can do for you. He's only getting blessed. But we pray, God, that your name is written in the book of life of the Lamb before the foundation of the world. As the Bible tells us, the only ones who will not be deceived in these days.
Amen.
The only ones who will not be deceived, Revelation 13:8 tells us, but only those whose names were written in the Lamb's book of life before the foundation of the world, they are the only ones who will not be deceived. May his own name be blessed. May his own name be blessed.
Oh, hallelujah.
Lord Jesus, let us stand. Let's keep going with the message.
Amen.
Another day, amen. Don't you thank God, amen. Brother, sister, thank God this morning, amen.
Thank God for his grace.
It's not preached only in words, but it is a demonstration of the power of the Holy Spirit. Let's bow our heads. Great God of the universe,
bear
your children with their hands raised before you, Lord Jesus.
The
few words that were spoken here, Lord, if I had said anything that was not in your will, Lord, I ask you to forgive me. Every brother and sister,
Lord,
bow their heads before you and have their hands raised to you. That means they surrender themselves unto you.
That means,
they surrender to you. That means they believe your word.
The word is the deliverer.
Every beloved brother and sister who came here this morning, they came, Lord, to see one another. They came, Lord, in your presence. You are a God of mercy. Our hands, we are raised before you. You know our needs, Lord. Lord Jesus,
may
you pour all kinds of heavenly blessings,
material and
spiritual blessings. Those who are in need of a job, no matter what it is, Lord, those who are in need of healing, those who are in need to grow your faith, in the name of Lord Jesus, your presence is here, Lord. You grant unto them, Lord,
oh, Seigneur,
the purpose for which they raised their hands in your presence, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the way you spoke to us, Lord. As you said, Lord, you would send Elijah the prophet before the great day will come. We thank you, Lord. We're not good nor worthy. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we pray, Lord. We thank you once again, also, Lord, for our precious brother Timothy, Lord. We will be saved as baptism, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus. May you make it possible, Lord. Because without you, there's nothing we can do. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we do pray.
Amen.
In the name of the Lord Jesus. Be blessed. Amen. Glory to Jesus.
Glory to Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Don't you see number
53 in the Only Believing Book?
It is good
for us to glorify the name of the Lord. There is a land.
Amen. Oh, qui bon tout bon.
That is there's a glorious land.
No,
brother, when you have this hope, you have this hope. You know you're going to live in that land. Brother, sister, we have too much evidence.
God
done too much for us.
The
prophet came and he visited that land. He told us what he saw. The land is real.
When
we leave this body,
we're
not going to become just a little spirit.
When
we leave this earth,
when
we leave this
old,
that's when we will become a true man.
Firstly,
you're not a true man or true man. But once you leave this old flesh, that's when you become real. Glory to Jesus.
Amen. Amen. Combien vous qui vous annoncez ça?
How many people want to go to that land?
Those
who want to go to that land, they sing in the spirit.
Those
who want to go to that land, they worship in the spirit.
Those
who want to go to that land, they recognize what God has done for them.
There's a land that is fair and Don't
you give God for his good? And his mercy? It's not something we're saying without lip. It's not our imagination. But it's God who came down in these last days. He was afraid of death before. But one day, God transported him over. God visited that place. When he visited that place, he didn't want to come back anymore. But God said to him, the work is not yet done. You have to come back. When the work is done, the work is done. You'll come back. That's just the reason why I said, you know, I can't wait to go home. You know, it's a deliverance from that. I can't wait to go home.
This world is not my home. This world is not my home.
All those who have received this revelation, you look at this world, it's not your home. You're just passing through. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we bless.
Amen.
We ask for the servant that will come forward and do the final prayer for us. We love the Lord Jesus. We love the Lord Jesus. God has spoken. God doesn't speak by chance.
How
much is brother?
Amen.
Is that your wife there?
What's
your sister? We're happy to see you. We're happy to see you this morning. May God bless you. May God bless you. And we wish this is not the last time. We wish something was said there. God is working. God is working. He is the same yesterday, and today, and forever. If there's anyone here this morning, we are going to receive the baptism in the name of the Lord Jesus. We're going to do a baptism. Go with us, why don't you? Get baptized. There's no more time. It's your day. Don't say you have time to do it. Today is your day.
Hello,
sister, don't you say? Don't say it as placed in a condition.
You
only see one thing. The things of this world. What eyes can show them. But do you know that everything your eyes can see is not natural? What the reality is what your eyes don't see. The things that you see, the real body, there is not the real body. The real body is your diaphora that you have.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Amen. Et la moindre fois, ça lui prie, nous demandons de recevoir Timothée, qui va recevoir le baptême de notre
Seigneur.
Amen.
Let's bow our hands for prayer.
Adorable Père Tisseur.
Alléluia.
You are the Almighty God, the Alpha and the Omega, the Master of every life and of every wealth.
Merci, Seigneur.
Amen.
For this moment solennel,
for this solemn moment, that we can spend in your presence, Lord. We ask you, please, O God of truth,
que ton Saint-Esprit,
that your Holy Spirit,
capable reposer sur chacun de nous,
Lord. Please, Lord God of truth.
My
beloved brother Timothy, we receive his baptism in your name, Lord God of truth.
Tant pis, Seigneur.
Thank you, Lord.
On va remplir.
May you fill him.
May
you keep him, Lord.
On va protéger.
May you protect him, Lord. Also, his family, O Lord God.
Papa.
O Lord, Father.
Nous va séparer,
as you're about to be dismissed, Lord.
Tant pis, Seigneur,
please,
Papa.
O Lord God of.
We
will not separate from your presence, O Lord. But we will leave this place. May you do it for us, Father. Not because we are good, not because we are worthy.
In
the precious name of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Timothy asked me to ask the congregation, if you want to go first, then you can have a little fellowship with him. He would like to have us come together with him to eat a little something together. How many people want to go have the baptism first? Those who want to have the baptism first, raise your hand. Those who would like to have the baptism done first.
Amen. Amen.
Those who'd like to go and eat first, raise your hand.
Okay.
Now, this is going to have the baptism first.